Okay, I wanted to give you a quick lesson on using Desmos. So I have gone over here to desmos.com and you just start graphing. And over here you're going to type in the equation or the function, and then the graph will show here. And I'm on page 7 in the lab manual, interpreting graphs, part 2. And I'm just going to do some of these graphs. So the first one, A, f of x equals negative x squared plus 1. You can type it in function notation if you'd like, or you can just use y equals. To use the square root, you hit the caret key, which is shift 6. I mean, to square it, not square root. And then you got to go to the right with the arrow button to get it out of that exponent spot, and then plus 1. So there's the graph of f of x equals negative x squared plus 1. And again, if you wanted to just put y equals, you could do that and it won't change it. And so now you can see what the domain is. The domain is a set of x coordinates. So this goes down to infinity, but it also goes to the left. This graph won't ever stop going left. So this domain is negative infinity to infinity. And if you just click where you think the highest point is, it'll find that for you. So the maximum value of this function is at the point 0, 1. That means that the range, remember, you can't start with 1. Remember, it's always got to be the lowest value first in interval notation. So the range would be negative infinity, comma, 1 bracket. Always the smaller number first. And then you can see why these are gray here. Desmos will find the x-intercepts for you as well. All right, so that's our first function. And then our second function is f of x equals the square root of x minus 2. So this one is a command that you can learn. If you want to put a square root in, you just type in SQR T, and then it'll change to a square root for you, and you want to put x minus 2 underneath, and there's that radical function, has that familiar shape. Now let's talk about this domain. You can see that the domain starts at 2 and goes to infinity. So I'll also show you how to put a table of values in. So in the next row, click there and then hit the plus for add item, and then you're going to click table, and it's got x in here and it's got y in here. If you click on the y one and get rid of it and just retype the expression square root x minus 2, then I think we might need to get rid of that. Yeah, see that x sub 1, that's a different variable than x. So what we'll do is just delete that. And so you see the how it's why it's undefined. When x is 1, there is no y value. So 1 is not in the domain. All right. So if we put 1.5, we're going to get undefined. So we wouldn't want to start our table until we pick numbers that are in our domain, and the numbers that start, the first number would be 2. And then we could put 2.5 in. I'm hitting the tab button to get quickly across. Hit tab once, it goes to the Y. Hit tab twice, it goes to X. So I'm just hitting tab twice quickly, and it'll plot these points for you. But see, you wouldn't want to put anything in for X that is not in the domain of this function. So it'll do that for you. If I flip the page and go to the next page 8 right now, let's do an exponential function so you can see that. So I can just delete that. And my exponential function that I'm going to graph is c, so that's parentheses 1 over 2. And then you're in the denominator, so hit the right arrow key and then a parentheses, and then shift 6, and then x. So that's the, let me get rid of the table of values for the last one. So that's what a exponential function looks like. And now you can see that this exponential function has a domain of all real numbers, negative infinity to infinity, but the range, the lowest it's ever going to be is zero, but is it ever really going to be zero? And if you keep zooming in, see, this graph, this exponential is going to get really, really close to zero, but never touch it. So the range of an exponential function is parentheses 0 to infinity. Okay, so if we put in the table of values, so we'll add a table and then get rid of that x sub 1 and just call it x, and then type in this again. I'm going to copy and paste it this time, so copy, paste. There we go. So I can put anything I want in for x. The domain is all real numbers. It's going to give me a large number if I put in a large number like that. If I put in a negative 1, y is 2. If I put in negative 0.5, y is 1.4. Negative 0.3. Okay, so if I put negative numbers in here, it doesn't give me negative values. What a negative exponent does is it flips this. So 1 half to the negative 1 is the same as 2 to the 1. If I put in 0, I'm going to get 1, because anything, any exponent to the 0 power is 1. If I put in 1, I'm going to get 1 half. If I put in 2, I'm going to get 0.25, and as I get bigger, as x gets bigger, y is getting smaller, and it's approaching zero. So there's this something called a horizontal asymptote that you can graph. Y equals zero. All horizontal lines are y equals. And I wish it wasn't black. Let me change the color. You can go over and change the color. You hit that gearbox, and let's change it to blue. Okay, you can also make it a dashed line. All right, so I'm done with that. So if I zoom in, there's this horizontal asymptote, y equals zero. And as x gets really, 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 really large, y is approaching zero. It's never going to touch zero, but it's approaching zero. So that's a little bit of info on exponential functions ahead of its time. All right, let me do one more, two more. Let's do a rational function. So that would be like d, and so that's f of x. My output is equal to 1 divided by, and Desmos is really smart. It, when you do divided by, it gives you that horizontal division key. So you don't need to put parentheses around that x plus 2. It knows it's a grouping symbol. And so here's our rational function. And again, we have something going on with the domain this time. And you can see that at negative 2, it's this branch wants to touch negative 2, and this branch wants to touch negative 2, but it will never will. And that's because, let's do a table. If I put a table of values in, get rid of that x sub 1 there, and copy this expression down here. Okay, and I've got some issues there. All right, so if I put negative 8, there's a value, it's right there, really close. If I put negative 3, there's a value. But if I put in negative 2, I'm going to get undefined. There is no y value. Because if I put negative 2 in for x, I get 1 divided by 0. And you're not allowed to have 0 in the bottom fraction. So it's undefined there. And I can continue to put plot points, so forth and so on. But this has a vertical asymptote at x equals 0. Rational function of, not x equals 0, x equals negative 2, because that's where it's undefined. And again, I don't want red. So let's change that to blue again and make it dash. Okay. So you can see a rational function is always going to have a vertical asymptote if there's an x in the denominator that doesn't cancel, and there's these two branches. And the reason it's there is because you don't want zero in the bottom of a fraction. All right, so the last one that I'll do is on page 11. It's just absolute value function. I just wanted to tell you the command. Remember, absolute value functions look like a letter of the alphabet. We'll see what they look like. So absolute value are those two bars. You have to type in A, B, S. And then parentheses, X. So instead of the bars, in Desmos, you have to type in A, B, X and A, B, S. And there's your absolute value. And it looks like a V. And it has a range from bracket 0 to infinity. Because this point is in the graph, so x is in this domain. I mean, 0 is in the domain, and 0 is in the range. The domain is all real numbers because it goes all the way to the left and all the way to the right forever and ever. So that's just a quick lesson in how to work with Desmos. I didn't talk much about this wrench. I might have to come back and do it later, but you can set the x and y axis, you can label them. There's a lot of things you can do, but right now, easiest thing to do is just kind of zoom in and out with your mouse. All right, so that's Desmos.